MVP. Yo, I'm chilling right here with my man, Crazy Race. Hey, yo, Race, tell him what's new with the Relevance Radio, man.
Relevance Radio, big announcement. You can find us now on the B-Side Show.net. Yo, every Thursday, 9 to 11 p.m.
About to get it on. We live on air right now.
Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Young Baka. You tuned into the B-Side Show form, the State of Battle Rap, where we get together once a month and discuss all things battle rap. And I'm honored to have some of you dudes here today. Well, honored to have all of you guys here today. So go ahead and introduce yourself, man.
Yeah, yeah. Jay Bentley, fourth quarter, man. Sitting here about to talk about this battle rap, bro.
There you go, man. Introduce yourself, dude.
How we doing, everybody?
Getting your Instagram game on.
Oh, yeah. I gotta make sure the followers are right.
Yo, man, what up, man?
I'm Prof Nasty, Fresh Coast. Shout out all my brothers and King of the Dot. We holding it down for the King of the Dot West out here, man.
That's right. What up? Epic Saga, furtherly known as Epic Nonova, repping the graveyard. Soul Attack Crew, what up, man? We in B-Side right now, you know what I mean?
Your name's Epic Saga now?
Epic Saga, man. Change the name.
Nice. Hey, man, who am I to say something? I'm gonna be middle-aged Baka in a couple years, so what do I know,
right? Yeah, you can't be young Baka.
And then it's gonna be over-the-hill Baka.
Yeah. And then it's gonna be washed-up Baka. Then it's gonna be go-home Baka. Good stuff. Yo, man, for the people that don't know you, don't know your influence of battle rap, go ahead and introduce yourself, what you do, you know what I'm saying? Everything you represent.
Man, you know, really, I just been around forever, man. A lot of my good friends run a lot of these companies, man. So I be at every battle I could be at. I support. I battled Grind Time. I battled King of the Dot. I battled all kinds of leagues and shit. But really, I'm just a fan of music, fan of rap, fan of talking shit. So you mix the two together, and
that's what battle rap is.
That's what battle rap is, man. So I've been around since day one, man. I used to freestyle battle over beats and. You know what I mean? Crazy shit. So when this format came around, it was just life to me. So,
I mean, correct me if I'm mistaken, but you actually had battles at your wedding, right?
Yeah.
The wedding I was invited to, but that's a whole different story. Don't worry about it.
Nah, don't worry about it.
It's all good.
Look, I had plans that day anyway.
Hey, it's cool, man. Right. Neither was I.
Look, everybody was invited. Anybody that came to my wedding got it. My open invite was on Facebook. I posted. If you want to come to my wedding, let me know. So the motherfuckers that
I'm
hit me
back.
I'm going to
go back and look at it. It's all good.
If you can find it, shit's got crazy on Facebook lately.
Yeah,
but.
Right? Go ahead, man. Introduce yourself. Tell them who you are, what you represent. You know what I'm saying?
My name is Prof Nasty. I represent the Fresh Coast, King of the Dot West, man. Basically, I've been putting in work for the teams, man. You can see me at every event. You know, I'll be hustling behind the stage, making sure the hosts are doing their thing, you know what I'm saying? I might be fucking grabbing tickets, or I might be at the VIP. Basically, I'm the guy you don't see. I help make this machine work. You know what I mean?
Hey, man, battle rap along with everything else in life needs stuff like that. Needs people like that. I mean, that's what I do, you know what I'm saying? I'm the dude in the background. Go ahead and introduce yourself, man, with your Queen Latifah key on.
Y'all about to set it off in here, though.
Hey, man, do it.
Bars.
Yeah,
bars.
I go bars. I go by Epic Saga, man. I used to go
Stop
by...
Stop calling yourself
hey,
that,
man. That's what it is now, man.
I don't even know who the hell Epic Saga is.
Just like your
we don't accept
right
that
now,
here, bro.
Be,
we know you.
You know? But yeah, I go by Epic Saga now. I'm changing it. It's official. That's it. You know what I mean? Got my green card and everything. You know what I mean?
Oh, that explains it. Okay.
Hey, he about to change his name to the print symbol.
You ain't even a name no more. You
that's
just
probably
a symbol.
Not gonna happen.
I know a lot of people in the last couple months that went from Juan now to John. So I assume that's the same thing, right?
Of course, okay. You know.
So go ahead, man. I ain't mean to step on your intro, it's all good, man. So.
You know, I represent Elephant Graveyard, man. It's basically a group of fools that just grew up in LA, man. I literally grew up in LA. I stay in the IE right now. I produce, I battle rap, man. I write, I record, I engineer, I do all that shit, man. I'm throwing an event soon.
That's the first topic. What's going on with your event, man?
Okay, man. Basically, it's a new platform out in the IE. It's called IE Evolve. My first event is going to be March 28th in Corona at Maya's Cafe. I got some dope-ass MCs on that card, man. Some dope-ass cats are going to fucking perform and battle. There's going to be performances, battles, fucking beer you can smoke outside. It's 420 friendly, you know.
Nice,
it's gonna
nice.
Be a dope event the same day, unfortunately, as the King of the Dark Grand Prix. You know, I had already been setting it up, but you know, it's the
hey,
same
man.
It's the same
get
day
in where you could get
I'm not
in,
stepping
man.
On toes though
Step
I'm not
on
stepping
toes,
on toes
baby.
Because
what we do,
it's an IE, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, man, it's gonna be fucking tight. March
28th. Who you got on that event, man? I know you got Crazy K, right?
Yeah. Let me actually look at the flyer. I got Key Casino.
I got
Key Casino versus Celestial. I don't know if you're up on game about Key Casino, man.
Yeah, man.
Dope battle rapper from the IE. Celestial, old school Grind Time cat, man. Dude gets all fucking I got DJ Penn versus Crispy the Buddha Head, Crazy K versus Michael Mill.
That's what I'm going to be hilarious. That's going to be
fun. I got some dope ass battles,
dude.
Man.
Yeah,
I even got Daisy Gomez, Harley Q, a female MC battling versus the homegirl Zay from the IE. So the whole event is like an LA versus IE low key type of thing, you know what I mean? But it's going to be dope and shit.
That sucks for IE, but I feel
like. All right.
Hey, man, why are you hating
that,
man?
All the IE that are tuning in right now, listen to you right now, but it's all good.
When you talk to Harley Q, tell what Young Baka said, what's up? You know what I'm saying?
Okay,
I try to hit up on Facebook, but it's like 100 comments and I get washed away and all that. Whatever, dude. It's all good. So like you mentioned, it's actually going to happen the same day as the Grand Prix, which, you know, you and your team are part of. Who's on that? I know you got Carter Teams versus Dental.
So it's going to be, I wrote it all down so I don't remember or don't forget this shit.
That's what I'm talking
about. It's going to be March 28th, King of the Dot Grand Prix. It's going to be round one. We're going to have Dental versus Carter Diem.
Yikes.
And AFTA versus Demetri Jones. That's going to be the first bracket, basically. Too. We got Everybody Knows versus Metro Cycle. It's going to be a fucking laugh fest. We got Why Not from Arizona versus Eason from Oakland. We got Young One, who's fucking dope as fuck, versus Chubby Sinatra. We got Prophecy versus Ronzi. It's going to be $10 at the door. Project Blow starts at 6. We're going to try to end it around 12, but you know how battle rap goes. Might go a little over, but
battle rap
we'll
time.
We'll talk about that.
Real.
We'll talk about battle rap time.
Yo, look out for my boy Prophecy on that card, too, man.
Check it out, man. I'm
boy's
check
a
it out.
Beast, man, from Arizona. Nasty.
So let me ask you a question. I know there's a lot of cats that will campaign to get on this event, get on the Grand Prix. How did you guys choose who you chose?
How do I say this? It's kind of like, you're as good as your last transaction. We take the best of the best.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, we have homies and all outlets, but we can't pull favors with people. At the end of the day, who put in the most work, who deserves it at the end of the day, and then whoever wins this, they obviously deserved it at the end of the day, you know?
I'm with you, man. So, this is the B-Side Show Forum. We ask questions. Who do you think is the favorite in that whole West Coast bracket, man?
Damn.
The guy that likes cats or
Carter Diem?
You know what? You know what?
Oh, no,
The thing is, I'm rooting for Dental and Carter Diem, but the thing is, they're going against each other round one.
Yeah.
So it's kind of, I don't know how they're going to do this, whether it's going to be judge or crowd reaction. Whether it's crowd reaction, it might go to Carter Diem just because he's so off the wall, funny. Just
hey, but it's going to be at Project Blow, though.
Yeah. Yeah. But,
which,
but
I didn't even think about that.
But
teams at Project Flow
is
crazy.
But if it comes down to someone's judging about bar for bar for bar, I'll give it to Dental. You know what I mean? So that's. I mean, I don't know who's gonna take it for the West Coast, but it just.
Yo, Demetri Jones is nasty too. Formerly known as Urban, he's crazy.
Him and Dental actually battled before.
Yeah.
Who got that?
Urban.
I'll let you get that. That's Dental's my boy. You know what I'm saying?
Come on, man.
Shout out my boy,
Dental. This is what we do, man. We get deep in the pools of the questions, you know what I'm saying? So you thinking Dental's the favorite in this one?
If it's judged on with judges, not crowd.
Well, I mean, is that what you guys are going to do? It's going to be judges, I assume. That's how we did it 2 years ago.
I don't really have that info right now, but
Tell him Young Baka said it should be judges. Whenever you talk to whoever you talk to.
Yeah, I mean, if we have judges, I think it will go to Dental just because, you know, it's bars, you know what I mean? But if it goes to crowd reaction, it might go to just Carter Diem just on fucking the laughing stock he's going to cause.
It could be hard,
you know?
Either way, though, man, because when Carter's polished and he's spitting back-to-back jokes and they're funny as hell, I mean, that's the same thing as spitting bars to me. It just depends on who's
very
judging
true.
And how they feel it, you know?
I agree 100%, man. Carter Diems. You see, you got that T-Pain shout-out the other day, right?
Yeah, that was sick,
that was,
right?
That was crazy. He's like, yo, I accounted for 128 of those views.
He was like,
that's crazy, man.
I'll spend a rack just to follow you around for a day.
That's crazy, man. So, yo, man, before I cut you off and you're introducing yourself, you said you actually had battles at your wedding. Who battled?
Yeah, actually, Urban battled at my wedding. He battled Beast Gatlin. That
certificate.
Man, yeah, that fucking battle was crazy, son. And then Dental battled. Dental battled Rifle.
Dental got invited to your wedding and not me? Oh, man.
Like I said, man.
Info, tell him he ain't coming
like
back to
the
piece. Like, Dental got invited and not me.
It was an open invite, son. If you wasn't there.
We looking that up. I'm going to get the Young Baka staff.
You
wildin'
if you wasn't there, man. You should have been
there. It's all good.
Have you seen that, though? Dental versus Rifle, man?
I have not.
I heard Dental got it.
It's crazy. Yo, Chris Wynn dropped that footage, man.
Yo, we have a whole history of footage, man. This B-Side Show Forum, this is what we do. You used to be associated with the Voice Box, correct?
Yeah, definitely.
Voice Box, it seems like they were moving up the ladder and they were making a lot of moves, and then suddenly just one day they were gone.
Yo, man, I don't like to to talk about people and stuff.
This is a webcast. We're supposed to talk.
This
is kind of what we do.
All in all, that company was run wrongly by somebody who didn't really know about battle rap. You know what I'm saying? And when it came down to it, everything that was supposed to be put on him tried to get put on me because I was the person in LA trying to show love to the people that I know out here. So I set up all the... The funny thing about it is all the footage, I had it. It was ready to go. The dude that filmed it got all the footage ready. The dude that ran Voice Box Battles is like begging me like, no, email me the footage first. Email me the footage first. I want it to drop. So he gets in touch with the dude that filmed him. And then he's like, mail me the SD cards. And then a week later, he calls me like, yo, I never got the SD cards. They're lost in the mail. And people are like, they think that they was mad because Daily Duels was smashing on Voice Box. Like, I mean, they killed him.
Daily Duels was a competitor at one time.
Daily Duels got spitters. There's still a bunch of dudes that are from the Daily Duels roster that are out there smashing. I took my first loss from a dude that ran Daily Duels. You know what I'm saying?
I have a couple comments about that. He did something dirty to me, asshole.
I like you though.
In the year, when was this? 2013, right?
Yeah.
In the year 2013, the fact that we're mailing SD cards blows my mind. That's number one. That's true, right? Why are we mailing SD cards?
That's like mailing physical cash.
Yeah, right? That's crazy, man. But, so I think that's actually where I met you was Daily Duels versus Voice Box. And then I was blown away by Daily Duels' performance, like you said.
That event was crazy.
It was a good event, too, besides Joe Cutter offering me pastries and everything. But that's been well documented.
But let the people know what Daily Duels is. The people listening, I'm pretty sure they don't know what Daily Duels is.
I'm pretty sure everyone that watches State of Battle Rap knows what Daily Duels is. I think you're better equipped to speak what Daily Duels is than me.
Daily Duels is basically a league out in the IE that was popping at a major time when, like, not a lot of leagues were popping out here on the West Coast. There was really nothing going on for, like, I'd say about a year or
90%
two.
Of them dudes got pulled into KOTD.
That's
Fresh
right,
Coast.
I would say the first King of the Dot Prove Yourself event, the whole card was Daily Duels.
Pretty much, the whole card.
That was real talk.
And speaking of Daily Duels, for the people that are outside that don't know, watching, whatever, we're actually bringing Daily Duels back.
That's right.
You know, a dude by the name of Young Box in charge of the company now, whatever.
Shout out to Crazy K and Lex D.
Man, Crazy K, he came to my show Friday, and I cannot express to you the clothes he had on.
That's just the type of person he is, though.
He had a short sleeve, white pink dress shirt, and then he had like camouflage pants with like open toe sandals.
Hey,
it was crazy.
The way I can describe his dress style is kind of like Weekend at Bernie's.
He's the most. You have to have confidence to wear stuff like that. You know what I'm saying? I'm a fat ass, so all I wear is black.
Zero fucks given when he walks in the room.
It's amazing, man. But like we were saying, the first battle actually being dropped on the new Daily Duels is actually a battle that you had against Jew. And I know you've been blowing up my inbox last 2 weeks about it, I think, which is actually finished. And it's supposed to drop tomorrow afternoon at 12 p.m. So, man, what was it like? You battled at We The West 10, 500 plus in attendance. Was that the biggest crowd you battled in front of?
It was probably the biggest crowd I've ever been in front of. And the weird thing about it was just like a weird experience. Like, because, you know, you had some performers upstairs. There was like three stages.
We the West is three stages.
Right.
You have one outside where you guys battled.
Right.
You have people upstairs on the main stage performing. You have people downstairs performing. So we stopped performances on the downstairs stage for you guys to battle, but we still had to have the upstairs going.
And you still heard the music a little bit, but you know what? Everybody just came through and saw the battle.
That's cool, though, because then you know the people that are in there watching the battles are actually there to see the people that are battling.
And they loved it, dog. Yeah. They ate it up, man.
It was crazy.
And honestly, the whole crowd, maybe not the whole crowd, but like 50% of the crowd was just not, they didn't know anything about battle.
No,
rap,
I mean,
you know what I mean?
That's what made it so cool is those people came, those people are used to seeing performances, they're used to going to clubs.
Right.
And when I made an announcement that, hey, we're going to have battles outside, people were like, yo, what the hell? I actually got feedback from about 15 people that said that's the first battle they've ever seen. And they were super excited. They were interested in you. They were interested in Jew. which is the craziest name in battle rap, Mexican dude named Jew. Yeah. But they were super excited. Like, yo, man, this battle shit's dope. Where can I find this stuff? And you guys killed it, man. I gotta admit, put you up there with no microphones in front of. There had to be at least 200 people in the audience.
Right.
You guys held your own.
I was there. That shit was cracking.
You guys held your own. You kept the audience captivated.
Right.
Because that's not a battle rap audience. That's an audience that came to see performance.
Yeah, yeah.
But they showed you guys mad love, and the pictures look amazing. Some of the pictures that my photographer took look great, because she's from the upstairs stage looking down on you guys. And it was awesome, dude. And once that battle comes out, man, we're really going to see what's up,
much
man.
Much respect, man. Any other time you want to do that, just hit me up, man. You have my number.
Let's do it, man.
Characters, we're going to do it again, right?
Characters. Yeah, we should set up a battle for characters. Speaking of characters, for the people that don't know, we're bringing We the West, which is my monthly hip-hop showcase. Last four shows, we had 400-plus in attendance. We're bringing that to the promoter, and I have to admit, a lot of that is thanks to you guys. You know what I'm saying? You were the first person I hit up, and you said, yo, let me host it. And I felt bad for you, so I said, yeah. And, you know what I'm saying?
He got jokes. But I was the first one he hit up, though.
Yeah,
I was the first one.
100%. I hit you up naturally because you running shit out here, you know what I'm saying? You getting shout out by barbershops and everything. You're a home.
Yo, hey, you know what? Hey, shout out my barbershop, On Tap Barbershop.
That's right.
First barbershop in the whole state of California have a bar. We got beer on tap. We're putting
the bar.
Yeah,
you guys have a bar?
Can't be mad.
Yes, sir.
Man.
We put the bar in barbers. You know what I mean?
There you go, man. Yeah, there you go.
Thirsty Thursdays, man. Come visit me, man.
That's dope. I think that's illegal, but whatever.
No. We actually have alcohol license. We fucking legit as fuck, man. So
that's dope, man.
We're the first one to do it.
Haircut. Just going to kick it.
Yeah, right?
We got people just get fucking faded, dude, and don't even get a cut.
For sure.
We call it getting faded while you get faded.
Hey, you guys are killing, man. Good class and all that. So, yeah, we should win the battle. You know what I'm saying? That'll be dope as hell, man. So, moving along, I have a couple questions for you. You're actually KOTT Fresh Coast, but then you're One Media Fresh Coast. For people that don't know, what is the difference between the two?
I mean, they're basically two different entities, but we kind of... It's kind of like you can't have one without the other. We've been building with each other for so long. It's kind of like, that's my brother. You know what I'm saying? So to say he's not me or I'm not him, you know what I mean? It doesn't make any sense, you know? I wouldn't build this big old event and not include you. You know what I mean? We're all going to roll together as a family, even though we are two different entities. But at the end of the day, we come together and we build and we make this massive event.
So speaking of One Media, right? On Media? What is it? What is the...
Oh, Fresh Coast Media Group.
Fresh Coast Media. So, you guys at EFA, obviously, probably the biggest battle rap event in history.
Of all time.
Okay, of all time. So, did all of you guys... I know you went, right?
Of course.
Did you go?
I wasn't there for that one. No, I wasn't.
So, just put your mic down. I'm messing with you. I don't even know why I'm picking
you. Were you there?
I don't even know why I was picking
you. Were you there?
I was in the back.
Yeah. I'm sure you were. Back.
I think I had a show or something that night. So, man, I know there was a lot of feedback from that, some negative, some positive. How was your whole experience about it?
Honestly, it was like the most nerve-wracking, nervous, but exciting thing. Because we didn't know what was going to happen. We never had a battle that big ever. No one's ever seen it that big. We had fucking superstars rolling in there left and right. You know what I mean? And to have Cassidy battle Disaster. This is a battle that people have been trying to see Cassidy for over 10 years. But nobody could afford him. You know what I'm saying? And then we got the cake and it was just kind of like, all right, let's see what happens. You know what I mean? No one's ever seen this before.
So do you think overall was it a good event or?
Yeah. I mean, facts are 800,000 pay-per-views. Fucking sold.
I didn't even know it was that much. That's crazy.
Yeah. Sold out. It was the biggest thing that ever happened. I mean, whatever happened at the end of the day, you could just look at what happened. We did something that nobody can ever do.
You attended as well. How was it that someone else just
attended? Yo, let me say too, man. I know a lot of people complain, especially people that are watching on the pay-per-view and shit like that. Yo, man, in the building, that was amazing, man. All the sound was good. The only thing that got messed up was the sound of the disaster and Cassidy battle. I feel like if the mics weren't cutting in and out, that battle would have happened on stage too, and that night would have went down in history. But because that didn't happen, everybody wants to start talking, oh, my internet was cutting in and out and all this bullshit. And it's like, bro, the battles that happened that night were ridiculous.
What were some of your favorite battles that happened tonight?
Oh, man. Big K versus Conceited. Crazy. Rum Nitty versus Billy Boondocks. Nitty went out of this fucking world. And then, of course, Daylight Serious Jones. That was nuts. That was crazy.
I saw Daylight Serious Jones. Speaking of Nitty, it's crazy how quick he blew up.
Fourth quarter, man. That's my score.
Yo, are you from the AC too?
Nah, this I lived in AZ for like 10 years, man. So, I mean, KG's my boy. Me and KG go back a minute. So.
Who just had the UOL Proving Grounds this last weekend, right?
And Nitty, see.
I was there for that. In Vegas.
Oh, were you
for
there?
I saw Run Nitty battle.
Oh, okay.
It was nasty.
Who did he go against?
I don't know.
Steams.
I don't remember who.
Steams.
Oh, there we go.
Okay.
There we go.
And
Steams is from UOL PGs. He just had a battle with, I think it was Prez Mafia. That was crazy.
Okay, cool.
But, yo, Nitty, people don't know, man. People, like, Nitty's on this rise right now, but I battled with Nitty in Grind Time, bro, 10 years ago. Me and Nitty have known each other forever, so I've seen Nitty battle for years. He's always been like that. People just didn't know him. He's been a killer, bro. In Arizona, whenever there was battles, they had their Grind Time sect out there, the Sand Trap or whatever. Nitty killed everybody. That's what he was doing. He's still out there, and he makes music, too, so... Forever, like I've known Nitty for a minute. He's been out there grinding for a long time. So for him to come up is, I mean, it's needed, man, because he's been around grinding forever. So for that talent like that, he's a monster, bro. He needs to be out there getting that.
I mean, just for somebody that's outside looking in, it seems like he's blown up in the last year. I remember I was in, I think it was Pomona, actually. Well, I don't know if you guys, you were there, I know.
Yeah, I was there.
We had, it was Cali Boy Smooth against Nitty.
Yeah, that was a good
battle. And it was just a one round, but now he's, you know, he's doing everything, and he's just killing everybody.
Yo, you know what it is, you know too? I think he did a smart move, man. I think it was B-Magic. He called out B-Magic, you know what I mean? It was saying whatever.
Rest in peace.
And B-Magic accepted it. And that battle was crazy. So, I mean, you know, after that happens, bro, you blowing up.
I mean,
and then he gave Arsenal...
Up,
He killed Arsenal, so, I mean,
yeah,
you know, when stuff like that happens, bro, you can't help it, especially with the way that Arsenal people are all over him. But right. Rebel never lost and all this shit.
I'm
and
in another motherfucking state, in another motherfucking nigga's face. That shit's so hard. I'll be walking on my office saying that shit. Niggas be looking at me like I'm crazy. I swear. I'll be telling the secretary, I'm like, I'm in another nigga's state. She's like, okay, whatever. In another nigga's face.
And he be doing that when he ordering food?
Yeah, man.
I'm in another motherfucker's restaurant.
So, yo, man, speaking of Arsenal... Arsenal against Mr. Fab, man. You see that? You see that go down?
I seen it, man. It was what a good battle, but I mean, everybody that I hear from, you know, that was there, dude, they were just like, you know, Arsenal didn't show up as much as, you know, they're used to Arsenal showing up.
But yo, but you I can't say that. No. They were in the Bay and
but
he was battling
it was
Mr.
a good battle.
Well, that's half the thing. That's half the battle. When you go against the Patriots at those stadium, it's tough. You go against Seahawks in those stadium, it's tough.
Yeah,
man.
But when you at a different level, okay, it's like this. I could battle Epic in his city, and then he could bring a bunch of people with him. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? He'll have the crowd. But when you're somebody like Mr. Fab, who has millions of fans,
that's very true. That's
his
city.
There's 100 people there that don't even care about battle rap. That no matter what he says, they're just gonna be So it's hard to judge something like that, especially when you're in the building and some people are just like, oh, the crowd was siding with Fab. So I mean, but
that's half the battle. This is battle rap. This is what we do.
That's true.
If the crowd gets you flustered, that's part of your performance.
Oh, yeah,
you know
definitely.
What I'm saying? If I get up here and I hit you with facts and you can't rebut, you know what I'm saying? Rebut it on whatever. It is what it is.
That's just a hard battle for Arsenal to win.
Right.
Yeah.
Jump
from the get go. Yeah,
I was there live. I don't really care about crowd reactions. I'm my own personal judge. You know what I mean? I felt Arsenal round one was so disrespectful.
Some of the most
disrespectful
stuff I've ever seen.
God,
dude.
Damn.
The shit he said. Compared to what he said against like the Soros or whoever, like this was the most disrespectful shit he's ever said in his life.
I couldn't believe he made it have Oakland alive. You know,
dude,
what I'm saying?
It got so bad they wouldn't let him finish his round. Like,
bro, when he said
Mr. Fab's family,
Mr. Fab will always be underground, but not as much as your mom's.
Oh my gosh.
He's
talking about his dad having AIDS and everything.
Yeah, dog.
It got to the point where people in the audience were like, "We're gonna fuck you up after this show." And Mr. Fab's like, "Yo, this is battle rap. We battle it right now."
What are we supposed to do?
Mr. Fab actually, like, there was kids there. His whole family was there. There's little 5-year-olds in the back to see. Like, it was a family function. So when he was talking about this fool's family, it got real personal and, like, you know, he's like, he took the higher road, you know what I'm saying? Like, hey, this battle rap, this is what we do. But Arsenal, I've never seen him that disrespectful before.
It like I said, I was surprised that he made it not out of Oakland alive, but that he didn't get a lot more confrontations than he did, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, he bounced right after that fucking
battle. I can imagine who you think Mr. Fab got that? You think Arsenal caught that?
As far as crowd reaction and and shit like that. Yeah, but
what
I
do
mean,
you judge about it, Lon? Do you judge it on crowd reaction? Do you judge it on?
I mean, honestly, we gotta keep it real here. We gotta keep it real because I mean, I am a battle rapper. Besides that, you know, but that too. But I'm a battle rapper, so I gotta keep it real. Like, I think Mr. Fab did way better than the average. You know, the average
that,
Joe.
That he did.
But I don't think he was.
He didn't beat Arsenal.
Yeah, he didn't. No. He didn't beat
Arsenal. I don't know
Arsenal.
How you could say that when Arsenal couldn't finish his round.
The Rebel never lost.
I don't know how you could say that when he couldn't finish his round.
Look, let me say this, man. Arsenal is not my favorite battle rapper. There's a lot of battles that I see Arsenal that people pump it up, and I'm like, whatever, it wasn't even that dope to me. But as far as battle rap, Arsenal was rude in that battle, bro. So it just, to me, watching it, I wasn't there live, you know what I mean? Watching on my computer and just listening for what it is. I mean, Arsenal was in.
But how can you say somebody won a battle when they couldn't finish the round? Couldn't finish the first round. You think he lost?
Well,
no. It was dope.
He couldn't finish the round because he kept getting interrupted by Mr. Fast Family. It was getting
that's so
much under their skin. They were like, yo, we going to fuck you up.
That's what
you
happens.
Can choke in a round and still win a battle. Right?
No.
That's true.
I don't think
that's
so.
No.
He Calico, right?
Hell the fuck.
No, the Lux Calico. That's a perfect example.
Come on, bro.
Someone that choked.
So, say, so
there's
so let
always
me say,
the exception to the war, though. You know what I'm saying?
Let me say
always
this, though. Let
but
me say this,
but Arsenal
though.
Did not choke. He just got interrupted. And he was like, let me calm down, and I'm going to finish my round.
Yeah,
he
was just like, so that's, but let me say
I
this, though.
You got to learn to lose.
Yo, if
sometimes
you mess up in your first round, and then you bar dude to death the next two rounds, you lose because you messed up in your first round?
Exactly.
Yeah.
Kind of.
You have a good point, man. You have a good point.
Like, I don't know, man.
All right.
But, so do you think Mr. Fab did the best out of the industry rappers that took a chance at battling?
No, I think so far Cassidy.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, I think so far Cassidy's on the best.
I think Mad Child's pretty consistent.
Yeah, I don't think you can even consider Mad Child because Mad Child came through and he killed him back then. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
You know, he was in Canada, another example of somebody in the hometown. You know what I'm saying?
But what about him versus Daylight, though? You know what I mean?
I haven't even seen it yet.
I think Daylight got that, man.
Mad Child said Daylight got him, so I mean, that's normally
good indication. No disrespect. We're just keeping it real here, you know, straight up. But
he's not sure for him.
No, you know what I mean?
He's always his disrespect, son.
Now, honestly, out of all the industry artists, I really felt Mr. Fab did the best because he had 3 5-minute rounds, and that's a lot to memorize for anybody.
And they were bars, though. They were battle rap rounds. Yeah. There's a difference
he
between
did have bars.
You writing a 16 for your song and then you writing a 16 for your battle rounds.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
There's
a
different.
Huge difference, and Mr. Fab had that. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, he definitely did. Yeah.
And the thing I liked about Mr. Fab, because a lot of people, it's different up there. Like, you write your rhymes, but you don't know if someone's going to react before your punchline. Like, oh, that was nice, and then it kind of threw you off. You know what I mean? But he stayed consistent. He did his 3 rounds. I mean, he did 15 minutes of rap up there. You know what I mean? Anybody else would have been like, wait, let me get a sec real quick. You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
That's rough.
He felt extremely comfortable on the stage as well. You know what I'm saying? Looked extremely comfortable.
In Oakland, he is the fucking king. You know
what
I'm saying?
I guess it's easy to say the king. He could be president of Oakland.
And then when he got E-40 and Too Short up on stage with you.
Right behind you, which was a great look for battle rap. I think the last 2 years have been... I mean, I think we could all agree battle rap's had the most eyes on them the last 2 years. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Now, what we did with those eyes on us is a different story. You know what I'm saying? Mainstream is finally looking at us, and you know, sometimes we raise the occasion, sometimes we don't. Like Hollow, I feel like Hollow could have done a lot better against Joe Budden.
Yeah, definitely.
You know what I'm saying? He was good. You know what I'm saying? He was good. He was good. Hollow, but I feel like.
He made Joe Budden look better than Joe Budden actually was
the
doing.
Fact that
very true.
He was hanging with him. I think if you say the same thing about Cassidy, too. The fact that Disaster made it look like Cassidy was hanging with him, I don't think he performed what he was supposed to perform to.
I think when these guys step in our ring, we're supposed to wash them, knock them out. There's no debate.
There's no
score. Like, no, he got fucking rocked. Every fucking round KO, and that's it. You know what I mean?
That's what we expect. But you know what? That's what happened with Cassidy. Cassidy did so fucking good. We're like, oh shit, he's hanging.
A lot of pressure. People, look, when you're a battle rapper, you're not this dude that's Cassidy. You're not in Dubai doing shows.
Exactly.
So the pressure
getting
for
paid
a dude,
50 G's for,
even Disaster. Disaster's one of the, if not the most known battle rapper in the world, one of the most known battle rappers in the world. It's a lot of pressure to battle Cassidy still. You're still battling somebody as far as money-wise and fan-wise, and they're above you in that status. So it's still tough to come out there. That's why I feel like Disaster's swag was thrown off a little bit.
But the fact, if you ever make it even close, I think we could say maybe Disaster won that, but the fact that it's debatable, he lost. Just because it's debatable.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
No, I understand.
And
that.
He put a lot of pressure on himself. Yeah, I think the same thing with Hollow. I think we could all agree that Hollow won, but the fact that it was even that close,
we're going to chalk it up as an L.
You know what I'm saying? Yo, with that being said, I got all these bills in my system. I'm going to take a piss. We'll take a break. B-side show. State of Battle Rap. We
Fresh here. Coast. Get in the dot.
Fourth quarter. Let's go.
Chilling right here with my man Crazy Race. Hey yo, Race, tell him what's new with the Relevance Radio, man.
Relevance Radio, big announcement. You can find us now on the bsideshow.net.
Yup.
Every other Thursday, 9 to 11 p.m. B-Side Show.
Hello, Dr. Green Thumb. Paging Dr. Green Thumb.
Hello, my name is Dr. Green Thumb. I'd like to tell you just where I'm from. In the hills where the trees grow.
What's up, this is B-Real, the Buddha Master, shouting out bsideshow.net, chilling at the Crazy Horse, Shabina. Sick Jacket from the Sick Ass Cycle Realm, shout out to the bsideshow.net. Sick Jacket from the Sick Ass Cycle Realm. Shout out to the bsideshow.net. Sick Jacket from the Sick Ass Cycle Realm. Shout out to the bsideshow.net.
Gentlemen, my name is Young Baki. You tuned back into the State of Battle Rap, I guess, whatever. Anyways, my name is Young Baka. We're back. Make sure your microphone's on. We're good to go.
Yeah, there you go, man.
So, yo, man, we were talking about EFER. You guys felt like it was a successful event. Are we having another one soon, or what's going on with that?
We got a really big one. April 18th is going to be King of the Dot, Back to the Basics. It's going to be at the House of Gods. Basically, what this is going to be, how it was back in the day. No entourage, no host, no judges. It's just two dudes in a pit getting on. Best man wins.
Who do we have doing that?
King of the Dot's going to be doing this one. What we have so far is main event. We got the Source versus Rone, which is going to be crazy.
That's going to be dope. Really dope, man.
And KG versus Head Ice.
That's going to be sick.
That's going to be dope. Dog. That's going to be dope. You think KG's getting that one?
Of course. Fourth quarter, man. We win everything.
I don't know,
bro.
Man. I don't know.
When's the last time a person in my squad lost a battle?
I don't know. I'm going to have to look it up.
It was probably me. And that was a long time ago.
So, yo, man. We're talking about
that didn't count.
We're going back to the basics on this one, but like we talked about, EFER was a huge event. I know we had some time management issues, and I know we had some time management issues at Battle of the Bay as well. Yeah. What do we do to fix that? Do we just accept the fact that we're battle rappers and we can't keep track of time?
The only thing we could, I mean, you as a promoter, you know, people are late.
I hate that word, promoter, but go ahead.
With somebody that does promote.
Businessman, there you go.
Yeah, but it's just a simple fact. Like, people are going to be late. Things are going to happen late. Like, these are things that are out of your control. So, you do the best with the time you can. And if you don't, you try to make it up to people. You
bro,
know what
you
mean?
Got here like 15 minutes late today.
What the fuck?
They're going to put me on blast, right?
Fire.
Well, thanks for coming to your State of Battle Rap. It's going to be your last one. Anyways, I'll mess with you.
No, but I mean, we always give the fans at the end of the day the battle they wanted to see. You know what I mean? Whether it was at the event or not, I mean, it's really out of our hands. You know what I mean? When a venue says, hey, that's it, that's it.
But as a promoter or someone that throws shows, that throws a lot of events, I know that if I do a show, I have to be out at a certain time. I have a curfew because maybe we have another show coming in. We have Bonda Night. We have a reggae night happening. We have to be out at this time. I let everyone know that. We have to be out at this time.
The club owners just want you to get the fuck out.
Yeah, exactly. Just because they have to keep their books. And I do a lot of shows. I've been doing a lot of shows lately. This last week, we actually had Joe Budden at Los Globos in L.A. We had Mick Jenkins at Los Globos in L.A. We had a cat by the name of Fodder who does some new ATL music. It's crazy. All of them had to be out at 10:15. And my big thing, once I got to the artist, once I got the manager, I said, yo, you guys have to be out at 10:15. They actually turned the lights on Joe Budden. And I said, hey, I told you 10:15, you guys got to be out there. We do that when we do shows. Why don't we do that when we do battles? Well, we let everyone know you have to be out this time.
I mean,
battle rap time, that's what we call it. Battle rap time. You know?
But that can't be acceptable anymore.
You're talking to artists that have clout. They have a whole entourage. Everybody wants to get in. Everybody wants to be on stage. So you're dealing with different personalities and people. You know what I mean? Then there's issues with security. I mean, we try to do our best as hosts and the team. You know what I mean? But it's just some things are out of your hands.
I feel what you're saying, but Joe Budden, this last week, he had the 40-person entourage. And I had to get them all in. And I had to get them all in the green room. I had to get them all checked. And, you know, we were able to do that. And I feel like with shows, especially, you know, in L.A., we do that all the time. You know what I'm saying? So as battle rappers, we gotta figure out, or people that throw battle rap events, we have to do something to find that, you know,
yeah.
find that common ground.
I do believe it's a learning lesson. Like, we're learning, you know what I mean?
Especially because we've never done stuff on this big of a scale.
Yeah, exactly.
Before,
so,
you know what's tough, too? When you're throwing a battle, and say your first battle starts at 3 o'clock, you got a line of 100 people outside. There's nobody inside. These dudes are supposed to battle right now, but the dude that's hosting the battle is like, man, I need those people, 100 people outside to be inside to see this battle. So
I
now
hear what you're saying 100%.
That's very lagging. True, man. Because
but you got to plan for that. You got to open up doors at 2.
Sometimes the intermission will kill you, man, because everybody want to go outside, you know, do whatever they got to do. And then you don't want to disrespect the battler and start the battle without the people there. You know what I mean? People pay good money. They got paid good money, and they want to bust in front of a whole crowd. You know what I mean? So we try to accommodate them, like, hey, well, we're going to get everybody in right now. Sometimes people don't want to listen, you know?
Yeah, man, it's tough. And I think battle rap, like you said, has never been to this big of a scale before. So everyone's trying to figure out how to do it. You know what I'm saying? It's easy for someone that throws a whole bunch of shows to say this is how it's done and everything. But so with that being said, what do you feel like is the current state of battle rap? How's things looking? Are we progressing? Are we walking backwards? What do you think's going on?
I think it's lovely, man. Like, real talk. Like, the whole world is now... I always compare battle rap to the UFC. It was just this thing that nobody really understood. It was underground. And then you got somebody like Dana White. They came through and they constructed it. They made rules. And then, you know, now people understand this. Now, you know what I mean? And at the... You know, the beginning of hip-hop, it was about the battle. Now we structured it. We got the three rounds. And I think the whole world's watching now.
So you think it's good?
I think it's great.
What do you think the corner say about it is?
Yeah, I think it's great, man. I'm seeing so many venues with thousands of people in there, man. And you know, it's funny, too, because people was on this URL thing for so long. It doesn't count if it's on URL. But I've seen so many King of the Dot events, especially within the last 2-3 years, that are just packed, especially in Canada. Thousands of people. It just looks ridiculous. You know what I mean? And for it to just grow like that and grow like that, and for me to go to events that were at the basement, and when we started, there'd be like 50 people in there. And then the last one we had there, it was so hot in that bitch because there were so many people.
Yo, it was crazy, right? I'll never forget that day.
It was
nuts. Crazy, man.
There were so many people, though, and that's good, man. If you could keep packing venues like that and people can really get into it.
But that's another thing where you have to accommodate. You have to know that this many people are going to show up to see the Sass against Cortez, to see Daylight against whoever the hell.
Yo, you know what the fuck is rough? And I just know it from looking on these forums, being a new person to battle rap.
Yep.
People are such assholes nowadays, dog. You say, yo, when does Disaster versus Cannabis drop? And the motherfucker's like, on your mama's birthday. You know what I'm saying? And then someone's like, yo, if there's a good battle to watch, let me know. And all there's just like 50 people on them talking shit.
Exactly.
It's rough, bro.
And
it's
honestly,
hard.
I think that happens in mainstream culture a lot.
Everybody's a critic,
culture, man. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Where you know what I'm saying? You start to discover like, yo, this dude, Wu-Tang Clan is dope. You're like, what the fuck you mean Wu-Tang? Of course they're dope. You know what I'm saying? And you get hated on. I think that's just how it is, man. Say the battle rap. What
yeah,
do you
but
feel
battle
about
rapper,
it?
But battle rap fans are supreme assholes and battle rappers because that's what it's
that's
about.
Right. They got the biggest
that's
opinion
true.
In the world. They'll
it's
let you
rough.
Know on YouTube all
to be,
day.
To be a battle rapper, you have to be self-absorbed asshole. You know what I'm saying? You have to think
word.
That you're better than everybody else. You know
you
what
definitely
got
to have a thick
yeah,
skin. That's
it,
for sure.
Be a rapper in
exactly.
general.
Exactly. I think if you're a rapper, you could be more sensitive. You could have different opinion. You know what I'm saying? Macklemore was talking about how he used to think he was gay. You can't say that in battle rap. Well, I guess nowadays you can because I've seen some stuff the last couple months. Daylight's
opening the doors
mind.
For that type of shit.
Daylight's
you know,
losing his mind,
key.
Man.
Yo,
what do you think?
Daylight just allowed to pretty much do whatever he wants.
He's a fucking genius.
Right, let's
man.
Talk about
straight
it. What do you feel about Daylight? What do you
all,
feel about Daylight?
Love Daylight, man. Daylight's a good dude. And,
yeah?
and not only that. Look at Daylight. Look where he's at. This fool's been in magazines, on covers, and all kinds of crazy shit that other battle rappers that are at a higher level or whatever you want to say of battle rap weren't at, especially when he was doing it because this was when he was trying to climb. So I feel like all the stuff that he did was genius, bro. Look, at there isn't a day that goes by that you don't look in the battle rap forum and someone's saying
can do whatever the fuck
something
he wants.
About Daylight. And he does it, and people are like, oh, it's an antic, and it's funny, and then there's half of the people laughing at it, half of the people saying, oh, you're gay, you're this, you're that, and none of the shit matters to him. That's why he's so genius, bro.
So this is our fourth State of Battle Rap forum that we've had, and every show I think we spend at least 20 minutes talking about Daylight.
You know what I'm saying?
It's just everyone that comes in here, we talk about
well,
Daylight.
Daylight
and
is
that's
the
what,
twice
yeah, and
to get you talking about
winning,
him.
And that's what
you know
he
what
wants us to see, man. So what do you feel about Daylight? You like the red bill or the blue bill?
Dog, I like Daylight is just dope, man. Either way he comes at it, man, it's fucking dope because I think what he's doing is he's basically immortalizing himself in battle rap. He could do whatever the fuck he wants because, like, that's who he is. That's fucking
and you
Daylight.
You can't deny the fact that when he's spitting bars, who's better than Daylight,
yeah,
bro?
I agree.
When Daylight is serious.
When he's spitting bars, who's better? He's nasty,
but
bro.
How did you feel about the whole Total Slaughter situation where he was laying mainstream rap is looking at us for the first time in a long time on this huge scale and he's laying there in his boxes. I was a little bit upset because I feel like he embarrassed us.
Yeah, a little bit, but at
he
the
probably
same,
just didn't have a third
but
round
at the same
shit,
time,
you know
dog,
I mean?
He
like,
just didn't give
well,
a shit.
Well, let's get into it, round. This is your job, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, but I feel like that. But I feel that like shit. That wasn't his job, though, and that's how he felt about it. That being on TV in front of these people, in front of these clowns who don't give a fuck about who he is and battle rap, that was for them. And
And the two rounds, the two rounds that he spit were ridiculous. I mean, the two rounds that he spit were crazy.
We can't think of one bar that T-Vac said that day. You know what I'm saying? But we're still talking about Daylight all these months later.
So who really
won? The only reason T-Rex won that battle is because Daylight did that. Daylight was scorching him the first two rounds. Ridiculous. So I mean,
what do you think about Daylight, man?
I love Daylight, man. He's a good guy. I mean, a lot of people don't know him. Like I see Daylight at venues. You know, my girl's really cool with his wife. You know, he's a good father to his son. He's a fucking dope dude. But he's smart. There's a method to his madness. And he said it at the beginning. Within 1 year, the whole world will talk about me.
He did say that.
And he did it. You know what I mean? Whether it's... He's done with the actors now. From what I know, he's done with the actors. Now it's all fucking bars.
I don't believe that for 1 second.
Anymore. Well, one of his best antics was against Sirius Jones. He took him serious. And that was an antic. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So speaking of that, who you think won that? Sirius Jones, Daylight?
I got to give that to Sirius Jones a little bit. I didn't really like the third round with his boys jumping in.
Dre Vicious and Beast Gatlin.
Because it was just kind of like he was doing dope. He was doing dope as fuck. So it was kind of like one of those things like, why you need these dudes? Like, I mean, they're dope in the respect, you know what I mean? But he didn't need that, you know what I mean? He should have just kept doing his third fucking round and iced him, you know what I mean? I do like you know, they'll do a bar and his boy will tap him. But then when he jumped in there, then, you know, the crowd wasn't feeling it at all.
Not at all. So, they wanted to see Daylight cook, you know
exactly.
What I'm saying? So, what do we think about the whole microphone situation? Because I knew that was an issue. Where they had the Britney Spears.
I don't like
they had the Britney Spears
rap.
Thing. If I'm a battle rapper, I don't want to hold a mic. You know what I'm saying? So, how do we accommodate that, though?
Sorry about that.
Anybody calling you after 10 o'clock, man? Hey, go ahead.
I said I love you, too. I got it.
Hey, I didn't see anything. I didn't see anything.
Honestly.
Well, I mean, it's graduated from just 100 people in the room where everybody can hear your voice. Now it's 1,000 people in the room, so you got to get amplified. And sometimes, you know, these are wireless mics, so there's feedback, there's fucking disconnection.
And you
things
can't
happen.
You can't wear the mic with the modem on your ass, whatever. And then a little coming up when everyone has big ass gold chains on. You know what I'm saying? Because that's all you hear is the gold chain. I think that's saying about battle up. Another thing that we've never been up this level before.
I know Big T
was trying to use a mic stand at EFO, right? Hey, how dope would it out of it?
That was cool, though. That was cool. Big T get a pass.
Yo,
that shit
Big
was nice.
T with the cut noises and everything, just simply amazing, man. So, yo, actually, when I pulled up this evening when I was 50 minutes late, like you pointed out to everybody and, you know, my bosses and everything, you guys were talking about the Shimon vs. Pat Stay battle, man. What do you think about the Shimon vs. Pat Stay battle?
I don't even know what the fuck I have to say about it, you know, because it was kind of like weighed out.
Show.
Yeah, my bad, man. My bad. I'm just keeping
imagine
it real.
Imagine if every answer was like that. Like, I don't know.
I mean, keep it real, man. I mean, I don't know. Like, I'm just kind of at that moment where, like, I don't even know what I got to say about it. Like, it was kind of weighed out. I don't want to say some shit that is not true. You know what I'm saying? Why do that shit?
What do you think about Shimon vs. Pat
Stay,
man?
Pat Stay, round one, body. That was like, I never seen him so polished.
Yeah, he was
you know
amazing.
What I'm saying? Sharon's round two, he got really personal with him, you know what I mean? Round three, just because Pat Stay's short in his round, you know what I mean? It was so short.
It was super short, right? And you could hear him at the end of the battle saying, I shortened it up a little bit.
Yeah, like, I don't even understand why you got to explain that. Like, you know, to me, that was a little bit of a cop-out. Maybe he forgot or maybe he was like, fuck it, I'm already over this shit. Maybe he thought, I won already, you know what I mean? I ain't got to do that, but I felt Sharon, just because he... You know, he shortened his round, and then Sharon had the, you know, all the personals, you know. First time you've been locked up is when you push your sister down the stairs. You hanging out with the person that ratted out your boy. Like, it was just fucking, it was crazy, you know what I mean? But it's debatable, but, you know, I'm not mad that Paste got the chain, you know what I mean? I felt to be the champ, you got to beat the champ, and it wasn't convincingly. It was debatable.
Yo, I feel like Pat just looked more polished in that whole battle.
Like he was saying, his punches hit a lot harder. You
dude,
know what I'm saying?
Yo,
it was
Pat's
just a lot of,
first
he
round
was, just
was
way more
out of this fucking world,
you know what I'm
bro. Yeah. I don't think I've ever seen Pat snap like that in my life. His first round was one of the best rounds I've ever seen in battle rap. It was crazy. And for that, I mean, that momentum kind of brought him through. His second round wasn't as strong as his first. We had a lot of funny punchlines. And I think Sharon got that second round. And I think Pat took the third. It was short, but I feel like he just looked more polished. Sharon kind of looked shaky. He kind of looked nervous. he felt like I could hear it in his voice. He sounded like he was shaking on stage.
Look me in my eyes when I'm killing you.
That was a killer.
That was dope. But I feel like he was. How do I explain this? He was forcing it too much. You know what I'm saying? Like against Shotgun Shug when he was telling him that, it was natural because he felt disrespect. He was throwing his back on him. But I feel like the whole
he just
Pat
said
Tate
it
thing,
to him.
Yeah, I feel like the Pat Tate thing was it was just forced too much. I think just like Pat said in his rounds, his lines and his punches just hit a lot harder than Shavone's. You know what I'm saying?
The punches don't mean nothing if you can't deliver.
Exactly. And I think the whole...
Oh, yeah. I think he had a line there. He's exactly. Like, the punches yeah, exactly. don't mean nothing if there's no power behind
exactly.
it.
Yeah, exactly.
And that's exactly what happened. I also think the whole what he was talking about, why would I battle on Smack and just have all brands blend into each other? So I'm going to stay here. I'm going to represent Canada. I'm going to do what I do.
That Sharon angle where he was telling him that he couldn't battle anywhere outside of his home, though, was
yeah,
was
yeah,
nice.
That was nice.
It was,
that
nice, was nice, but I felt like it didn't hit as much. You know what I'm saying? And that's just comes back to the same thing we talked about. Yeah?
I'm with you. I saw it from home. I don't know how it reacted there or resonated there, but from home I was like, damn, he really speaking some shit right now. When he was like, you know what, I'm not even talking shit, I'm on my grown man shit. And he was talking to him, you know what I mean? And it was kind of like, he's telling the truth, you know what I mean? Like, you never battle for any other league because this is where you're comfortable and this is where you're home.
He hasn't battled for another league, has he?
Nah, never. Not that I know of.
Yeah, I can't think of that. And why do you think that is? I mean, he'd make a lot of money, let's be honest. He'll make a lot of money battling for Smack or something else.
I mean, he could battle too. I mean, it's not like he's – I mean, obviously, he's the king of the dot champ. Yeah. So
With three straight title defenses, right?
Yeah.
He defended it against Disaster, Shavone, and Daylight. Another battle that's
Daylight's
a strange
bars
battle.
In that.
When he was talking about all the white rappers from King of the Dot.
That first round was crazy.
It was dope, man, but I felt like
that antic lost it for him.
It was too heavy for the people.
Dude, he was cooking so hard, and then he would just pause and like talk to Slayer Master. But I don't think Daylight gives a fuck.
You don't think he wanted to be champ? I think he wanted to be champion.
I think he would want to be champ, but I don't think that he necessarily really gives a fuck either way. Yeah. Now that it's over, I don't.
Yeah, definitely.
So do you look down about him? Shout out to the guy with no microphone speaking.
It's tough to be the King of the Dot champion and not be battling people from other sectors of King of the Dot.
What do you think about that?
It's kind of one of those.
Every battle rapper has to.
You never left home.
Of his own.
You know what I mean?
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That's just something.
It's tough because I could understand where it's hard to respect, but I mean, it's undeniable that the dude can rap. So I mean, the bars are universal, right? So the point, like, if he would have battled Sharon,
I think Pat Stay would kill if he goes to.
I think so too.
I think he would just. He would walk up on that stage and people would just love him. I think the same thing in Cali. If Pat Stay comes to Cali, he
cool
would kill it
too.
Why he doesn't do it, I don't know.
I have no idea.
I mean, maybe it's one of those home field advantages he feels. If he goes somewhere else, he might not get us. But he's nice, though. That's what I don't understand.
There's a lot of money just waiting for him out there. You know what I'm saying? So you don't collect those bags of money. This is your job. So.
I mean, I know there's no, like, legal reasons why he can't come out here. You know what I'm saying? But, I mean, I don't see why we can't get him down here. You know what I mean? Maybe he just doesn't feel comfortable coming down here.
He's still going to rap the same way he raps. So
yeah,
I
think it would still kill. So who do you think is next for Pat Stay? Who do you think has a shot at that chain?
Well, I mean, at this point, it's kind of like who's next for Mayweather besides Pacquiao? But it's kind of like,
who's getting that, Mayweather or Pacquiao?
Mayweather.
I think it's tough to hit him.
You know what?
Exactly. You got to hit a dude to beat him.
It's tough to hit him.
It's kind of like my heart says Pacquiao, but my brain says Mayweather. You know what I'm saying?
That's the perfect way to explain it.
We'll talk about this on B-Side Show, Sports Show, but go ahead, man. Who do you think is next for Pat Stay?
It's kind of one of those things, like, he's not battling to battle people. People are battling to battle him, so really, who's in line for him?
There's a lot of people that want that chain, you know what I'm saying? Who do you think deserves that chain?
who deserves it.
Great question, man. Because Siobhan was supposed to be the chosen one.
I don't know who deserves it, but I know who would give him the business. I think Caustic would get at him pretty nice. You know what I'm saying?
You think Caustic? I like Caustic a lot.
I love Caustic.
I think Caustic's stay nice.
It's hard to beat Caustic because
Caustic
the
is definitely Pat's.
I don't think so.
He's one of the rudest dudes in the game too. And not only that, off the top and Ritten's. I mean. Caustic's nasty.
He proved it, man. Real
Caustic's
shit.
Nasty, bro.
I like Caustic a lot. Caustic's one of my favorite battle rappers.
Look what he did
Bryce
to Verb.
Thing.
Everybody was talking about Caustic, hey, and he did Verb something dirty, bro.
What about
and
Jefferson Verb's, Price? That's still one of my favorite battles is him against Jefferson Price and shit.
That shit was crazy.
You know, I think Big K gave him the business, too. Big K.
You think Big K would hit like that in Canada against Bat Stay?
Big K is a fucking monster. You can't stop this dude at this point, man. He's just everything. People have setups. His are punch, punch, knockout. Punch, punch, knockout. That's all he does. That's all he knows. That's all he's like.
And that's a good strategy against Pat, because he has, you know, a good grasp on the punch lines. You know what I mean? And he's funny, and he talks to you like a grown man. He's a big dude. You know what I mean? Big K is not the type of dude that's getting bullied out there. You know what I mean?
So yo, man, we had a lot of great conversation. Except Epic, he didn't really know what to say. But besides that, man. Tell us what's next for you, man. What's going on? You going to find that voice box footage for us or what?
Man, you know what about the voice box footage?
Seriously, what's going on with you? What's next? What's popping? Fourth quarter?
Man, honestly, you know, I chill, bro. I sit at home. I got a studio at my crib. I make music, and you know what I mean? My boys are
living
out there
the American
battling.
Dream, right?
Yeah, man.
I think that's what everybody wants.
I'm a dad. I got kids and a wife and shit. You know what I mean? So I be at the events. I make music. I might possibly battle sometime if it feels right. You know what I'm saying? But in all honesty, the only reason I don't battle is because I mean, I'm a full-time dad, bro. It's hard for me to sit down and take the time that it takes to write and memorize a battle when I got a baby running around and shit.
That's,
you know,
another thing I've always been I've questioned as someone looking from the outside in. How do you feel when somebody talks about your kids? It's like when you're a battler, you know what I'm saying?
I'm gonna kill that motherfucker.
It's something that if you battle, it's something that you get over within your first few battles, bro, because
you have to, right?
So, and the thing about it is 99.9% of the time it's not even true. So you just sitting there taking it because that's what it is. Dog, it's hard to write a battle without saying something like your mom, your girl, your
exactly.
It's hard because you grew up roasting people. Yeah. When you roast a motherfucker, you say your mama this, your girl that, your sister
and,
this.
The way I see it, exactly. If you let a dude get under your skin to the point you want to fight him on stage,
wins, right?
You lost. You lost. You let a dude get you that heated that you want to scrap. You can't even.
You shouldn't battle.
Yeah, exactly.
Exactly, yeah.
Shouldn't
What's
battle.
Going on? What's next for you, man? I know you guys got all these events coming up.
Check it out. We got a bunch of things. Shout out my boy Malathion. If you guys haven't already peeped it, check out his Yellow Seed album. You can get that at chamberrecords.com. We got Time.
You tell him to chill, right? Like, let's tell him to chill just a little bit. I told him that the other day.
No. I love when Malathion does that because it's needed sometimes. Like, dude, like, you guys agreed both for, you know, whatever, 1 minute rounds. And you're doing two. It's not fair to the next dude. You know what I'm saying?
So I agree 100%.
He's just doing his fucking job. You know
like
what I'm
super
saying?
Animated with it and shit. No. He's going to start coming down with his leg. Like,
no, but it's kind of like Bruce Buffer. Like, are you ready to run? Like, it gets the crowd hype. Like, you know what I'm saying? That's what he does, you know? But, yeah, you can get his album, Yellow Seed, at chamberrecords.com. We got March 28th, the Grand Prix. That's the King of the Dot event. We got, and then April 18th, we got the, what do we got? We got the Back to the Basics. May 15th, the Boston Massacre. That's something coming up that's going to be dope as fuck. And then we got Ether Weekly and the Ether Cam with Lush One hosting and shit. You can find that on filmontv.com.
I think you're doing something March 20th too, right?
Oh, no.
We the West Pomona.
I'm going to be performing
at your
show.
That's why I get paid the big bucks, man. That's why I get paid the big bucks.
Yeah, I'm going to be performing at your show, man.
There you go, man. We the West Pomona, March 20th. Epic, what's going on? I know you got your event coming up. What's popping?
Yeah, man. March 28th in Corona, Maya's Cafe, man. We got some dope-ass battles.
Man, that's my event, dog. What's up?
Yeah, man, it's gonna be a Corona Sonata, man. I'm not trying to step on toes. You know, I've been planning this event, by the way. You know that personally.
Yeah, he does.
All right, but yeah, man, we got that event. Just look up I Evolve TV on Facebook. March 20th in Pomona. We got that shit cracking. We the West.
Go, man. We the West Pomona.
Yeah, yeah.
It's my first IE show, so I'm pretty excited. You know
gonna,
what I'm saying?
It's just gonna be tight. Pomona's actually LA County. Always... Pomona's actually.
Oh, man, you know what? That's but, you my know, other dude told me that
it's
too.
Technically the IE.
Pomona's IE. I don't care what nobody says.
Yeah, yeah.
I made that decision.
I've been saying
Pomona's
that shit.
IE.
It's a 909 area code.
Yeah, man. Pomona's IE. I'm making that decision. Let them know I said it, man. Anyways, dude.
Yeah, we also got the 420 show, Sunny Days and Vibes.
Tell Pomona.
It's going to be at Maya's Cafe in Corona.
I got this in Pomona.
And also, the homies from Velodio, no, you know, Denter, right? They're doing a Spanish league. It's called Velodio Legal.
Yeah, man, that's been killing it, dude. That's
Sunday, right?
Blowing
the fuck up, man.
That's this Sunday, right?
That's this Sunday at the
airliner.
What's
the date on that? Yeah, yeah, the airliner.
It's going to be at the airliner. What? Sendog's going to be there, right?
Sendog's going to be hosting that shit. It's going to start at 7. So roll up early, man, at the airliner this Sunday. Velodio, Spanish battle rap, Denter, fool.
That's fucking a great, that's,
Mata,
that's
straight
a great
up.
Ideal, she's
gonna
man.
Be dope. They're blowing up in
their
Mexico,
events
dude.
Are getting stupid right now.
Yeah, I've seen the pictures, man. It's crazy.
Mean,
I'm actually gonna try to stop by this Sunday.
Up, man.
Yo, bro, like, their first show had 100 domes. Second one had 200 domes. Then they threw another one with a free taco, man. 300 domes. Like, it was
How many
crazy.
People speak Spanish and love rap, though. You
exactly.
Know what I'm
now we got
That's
something.
A good
now
point,
now,
man.
Now
That's
we
a
got
good
something
point.
To represent us. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly,
that whole
dude.
Latino thing. You know what I'm saying?
Because keep it real. It's hard for a Mexican to come up in hip hop in general. Who in King of the Dot?
I don't think I like what you're saying. I'm cutting you off. But go ahead.
No, it's all good, man. In King of the Dot, how many Mexicans are there, dude? Nobody. Yeah. Like Z.
Me?
You know what I mean, Prof?
But I'm the dude sweeping after the event.
It's crazy. It's hard for a Mexican, man. Keep it real,
man.
But we finally got something going.
I'm with
for
you.
Them, you know what
I'm saying? Your battle's also dropping tomorrow, 12 p.m. You against
Daily
Jew.
Duels.
Daily Duels. The first battle in a long time at We the West End in front of 500 people, man. Once again, you killed it.
Thank you, brother.
You know, I don't want to give it away, but you pulled out the whole Mexican mask and everything. Absolutely killed it, man. So, yo, man, it's been the State of Battle Rap. My name is Young Baka. Thank you guys, as always, for tuning in. You know, we got a lot of fans coming up. We the West 12-1-12, right, Nympho? We the West 12 going down next Friday night at the airliner, March 13th. March 13th, 2015. I should have asked him for information. This Saturday, we got Unlabeled Volume 3. So, we got a lot of stuff coming up. Check the Instagram at Young Baka. I appreciate you guys coming through, as always. You
yeah,
know what I'm
yeah,
saying?
Yeah, man.
Fresh
it's
been B-Side Show, down, State man. Of Battle Rap, man. We out.
On
Young
Barbershop.
It's just
what?
Different the set.
Graveyard.